Greetings everyone and welcome back to another review. I'm sorry for posting two headphone videos in a row, but I simply have to show you guys this. These are $50 Bluetooth headphones with excellent sound. They sound absolutely amazing, more like $100 headphones or more. I wouldn't have expected this at $50, and this once again proves what I said in the last video. It is not always price that dictates quality. So this, my friends, is the Tribit X3 Tune. These are impressive over-ears that can be picked up for $50 right now on Amazon.com. So let's dive in and see what these actually bring to the table, not just in terms of sound, but build quality and the likes. Now, just judging the aesthetics, they look pretty modern but good in my opinion. The outer frame is plastic but comes with a nice rubberized soft coating, thus making a more expensive impression. However, do not worry, to my surprise, when it comes to build quality, it's actually very solid. Yeah, sure, they wobble a little more than most other headphones I've tested, but I don't think you need to worry about them breaking, since the construction underneath is metal as far as I can tell. Pretty thick, sturdy metal in fact. So build quality wise, very solid indeed. As far as accessories are concerned, the usual stuff such as a 3.5mm audio, as well as micro USB charging cable, and the rest is manuals and stuff like that. Adjusting the size does work well, but I have the impression we aren't getting quite as much choice as with certain other models, and the ear cups don't offer much flexibility. Nonetheless, a good fit on my head, although not the very best to be honest. But of course, don't get me wrong, the comfort is good with all that nice soft padding going on. I'm just super picky, you know? Also, if you are more into lightweight headphones, the X3 Tunes might not be for you, since at 288 grams, it might be considered a little heavy, but I'm perfectly okay with that. And for those wondering, yes, these can be folded like that for more compact transportation, but no swivel action on the ear cups, obviously. All the functions, such as the multifunction button for power and whatnot, as well as volume up, down, and next previous track buttons are located on the right ear cup. Same goes for the micro USB charging port, which comes with that cover that for some reason won't stay on properly on my specific model. On the left ear cup is the 3.5mm audio port. And that's it, a fairly simple model all in all, no noise cancellation and all that kind of stuff, but to be honest, I'm not really into the whole noise cancelling stuff anyway. This means all that is left to talk about now is the sound quality, and let me tell you, that's pretty impressive audio output here. A very clean sound all in all across all frequencies, but it seems most brands aim for that super punchy bassy sound. Lots of bass there, not so much my taste, but hey, the audio quality is great and it's nothing a little equalization wouldn't be able to fix for me. However, I get it, the majority loves bass, so that's not a complaint, I'm just pointing out. Now, in terms of battery capacity, I'm not sure what source to trust here. The website says 680 mAh, the manual states 420, so I'm guessing the manual is right. Either way, the battery life seems to be good. I've listened to music a couple of hours, but sadly my life is too busy right now to test out how much music playback time I could get out of these X3 Tune headphones. But it is 24 to 40 hours according to Tribit themselves, depending on the volume level of course. So why or how could Tribit achieve this and make such a good product for just $50? Well, my theory is they didn't waste any money on neat useful accessories such as a carrying case, something you get with many similarly priced models from the competition. Therefore, they could put the money to good use and focus on real good sound and pretty darn good build quality. At least that's my theory. Right now, sound-wise, they're in the same class for me as Tautronic's TTBH21s I mentioned from time to time. The only major difference here with these from Tribit, they are much sturdier and actually really well made. So the bottom line here is, these are great sounding, well-built, affordable Bluetooth headphones. Sure, they may not be absolutely perfect in all aspects, but they are close, especially at that really attractive price of $50. Without the slightest doubt, these Tribit X3 Tune headphones deserve my gold award. And as always guys, thanks for watching.